The lens correction panel also has a manual option. So you can click on that manual section and kind of see the other options that you have. I'm going to zoom into this fish here because there's quite a bit of purple fringing or chromatic aberration around it. I'm going to go back into my profile section though, and I'm going to click on that remove chromatic aberration. And you can see it does a pretty decent job of removing it, but there's still a subtle amount of purple in that shot. So if I go back into manual, I can actually go into the defringe section, move that slider to the right, and it's going to really desaturate those purples in that image. You can also use the eyedropper and you can find colors. There is not really any chromatic aberration left here, but you could find a color and you could click on it and it should remove that fringe area. There's also a setting for the hue, so you can specify the specific hue of purple, and then also the same for the green. If you have a green fringe, you can increase that slider to the right, and then you can also change that hue as well. Some images, even if you do have a profile for it, you may not even want to use that profile in the image. And this is a really good example of that type of photo. So I'm going to go back into that profile section. And if I were to click on enable profile correction, it's really weirdly distorting this photo. Now this is photographed with a fisheye lens. And so I want that distortion. So I don't want it to try and fix it for me because you can see it's just doing really weird things. So I'm going to uncheck that. And now I can go into the manual. And I can, if I'd like, I can change that distortion. I can increase it and kind of make it even more fisheye if I would like to, or I can remove some of that kind of that bulby fisheye look. And at the bottom, you also have a vignette setting. So you can decrease or increase the vignette and you can change the midpoint. Of course, this can also be done in the effects panel as well. I'm gonna jump to another photo so you could see another type of image that this would work with. You can have a little bit of fun with the distortion setting, and I can kind of make this image look a little bit thinner or more skinny is kind of the best way to describe it. If I move that slider to the right, it's kind of squeezing the photo in, but it's also making the waterfall a little bit more upright. I'll toggle that on and off so you can see. But now I have all of this leftover white on the sides of the image. I could go into the crop tool to fix it, but the fastest way is to just click on this constrain crop button. And that will delete and remove all of that white. So now if I toggle this on and off, it's still cropped, so just keep that in mind, but it is showing me the difference with that distortion setting moved to the right.